and the algebraic conditions for normal life. So we will see what is an equation. It is very important to know the fundamental things. So an equation is an expression having equal to sign. Example, I equal to P into R into P by 100. This is a simple interest formula. Interest equal to principal amount multiply by rate multiply by time by 100. And this is an equation because it contains one equal to sign. Here you can see one equal to sign. So that is why it is an equation. Whether it is linear equation or not, we will learn. But this is certainly an equation. Like area of a triangle, a rectangle, A area equal to A into B, where A is the side of a rectangle, B is the length and A is the width of the rectangle. Area of a circle, that is A equal to pi r square, where r is the radius of the circle. So this everything is an equation because it has an equal to. Then a very obvious question would be, but what is not an equation? I understand this is an equation. And what is not an equation? Not an equation is something which doesn't contain equal to sign. This is called inequations. Example, suppose there is a triangle ABC and this side is called A, this side is B and this side is C. So yeah, Gaurav, ask. Yeah, Gaurav, you want to ask something? Okay. So, if the sides are ABC, then any two sides of an angle, sum of any two sides of angle is greater than the third side. So, suppose this is A and this is B, then A plus B is greater than or equal to C. This is called inequation because it doesn't contain equal to sign. It contains equal to, greater than or equal to sign. Yeah, coming. Inequation and linear equation is two different things. Inequations means any expression which does not contain equal to sign. So if this is whatever I have written A plus B greater than or equal to C, it is inequation. Now your question is, what is linear equation? I am coming to that. Then what is equation? Equation is the any expression which contains equal to sign. So all three examples above are equation. This is inequation. The next question would be, what is then linear equation? Linear equation is anything which contains any algebraic equation which each term is either a constant or the product of a constant and a single variable, like this 3x plus 5y plus 9z minus 16 equal to 0. This is called linear equation. Why this is called linear equation? First of all, it is an equation because it contains equal to sign. Now, what is linear? Linear means all the variables in the equation will have maximum one power. Here it is written 3x. So it is x to the power 1, 5y, y to the power 1, 9z, z to the power 1. So this is linear. Linear means the power is 1. This is a linear equation in three variables. Now, Gaurav, can you tell me, this I equal to P into R into T by 100 is a linear equation or not? या गौरव I equal to P into R into T in by 100. Is it a linear equation? No, Gaurav. It is not a linear equation because see the definition. A linear equation is an algebraic equation in which each term is either a constant or the product of a constant and a single variable. Here, it is the product of two variables. P is a variable and R is a variable. It is product of three variables in fact. So this is not a linear equation. Now, A equal to A into B, area equal to length into breadth. Is it a linear equation? Gaurav? I have given you Gaurav speaking, you can also speak, Gaurav, I think. Look, here, I equal to P into R into T into 100. So, this is the product of three variables. What is linear? What is linear? Linear means when each term is separated by either plus or minus.
Okay, sir.
Right. So each term is either plus or minus.
So no, sir.
Here, this is entire is one term, and one term is product of three variables P, R, T. So it is not a linear equation. This is also not a linear equation. The second one. Now tell me, area of a circle, A equal to pi r square, is it a linear equation? Very good.
Yes, it is.
Speak for a while. I think your mic should work. I have given you the mic permission. I can hear. Yeah, I can hear you. Gaurav? Yeah, so A equal to pi r square, is it a linear equation? Very good, because it contains a square. So, that is why it is not a linear equation. Linear equation will be anything that 3xy plus 2pq plus 5r equal to 0. Whether this is linear equation or not, Gaurav? No, again it is not a linear equation because it is product of two variables, 3x into y. Whereas I am telling you the linear equation is each term is either a constant or product of a constant and single variable. Here, the first term is the product of 3x and y. So, it is product of two variables. That is why it is not a linear equation. In linear equation, you will have like this, I am telling, 4x plus 9y plus 8z equal to 7. This is linear equation because each term is either constant. Look, this is either 7 is either constant. 8z, it is a multiplication of 8 and z, single variable. 9y, 9 and y, y is a single variable. 4x, x is a single variable. So each term have only single variable. That is why the second one is a linear equation. The first one is not a linear equation because it contains product of two variables. I hope it is clear. Now, x square, so I am giving this sign for x square, just a minute. Suppose this is a square, 2 plus 2xy equal to 0. This is linear equation or not? Gaurav? Very good. This is not a linear equation. Yeah. Now I am giving you another equation. (45x + 67y) = 100. Tell me, this is linear equation or not? Yes, very good. Yeah, so this is a linear equation because each term contains either a constant, that is 100. 100 is a totally constant. Either a constant or product of a constant and the single variable, that is x and y. Importantly, first power of x, if it is 45x square or x cube, it is not a linear equation. So I hope, Gaurav, you now understand what is a linear equation. What is the equation? Any mathematical expression which contains equal to sign is is equation. What is linear equation? A linear equation is an algebraic equation. Algebraic. Remember, e to the power x is not algebraic. Sine x plus cos y equal to 3 is not algebraic. That is trigonometrical function. So, any linear equation is an algebraic equation in which each term, what is term? Term is each thing separated by plus or minus. Right? So, 45x is a term. 67y is one term. Is either a constant like 100. It is either a constant or
x equals minus
product of a constant and first power of single variable. 45 into x. It is very important. First power of x. Right?
Minus 5.
So, 3x plus 5y plus 9z minus 16 equal to 0. This is a linear equation in three variables because it has x, y and z. Three unknown variables are here. That is why it is called linear equation in three variables. Now, I am giving one very simple problem. If x plus 5, if x plus 5 equal to 0, that is, the meaning is correct. So, what should I add in 5? So, answer will come 0? Minus 5. Correct. So, x plus 5 is 0. So, x equal to minus 5.
X equals 100 minus 5.
So, this is a linear equation, but in single variable. So, fundamentally, a rule you must remember, if your equation have a single variable, to find out a solution, you need only one equation. Like x plus 5 equal to 0. Now I am giving you an equation with two variables. X plus y equal to 100. Alternately, you can think it is the income of Gaurav and Gaurav father both is $100. Now, what should be the solution of this equation? Tell me, the first equation, I am asking x plus 5 equal to 0, that means what should I add into 5 that I will get 0? Very clearly you told x equal to minus 5. So if I add minus 5 with 5, I will get 0. Now my second question is, x is the income of Gaurav and y is the income of Gaurav's father. The two sum is $100. My next question is, what is the solution of this equation? The solution of this equation may be 50 rupees Gaurav salary, $50 is Gaurav income and 50 is Gaurav father income. So both are 100. Then Gaurav will say, no sir, it is not the case. $80 is mine and $20 is papa's. Then again it is 100. Then somebody, your papa will say, no, this is wrong. $70 is my income and $30 is Gaurav income. And again it is 100. So, if there are two variables and one equation, there will be infinite number of solutions.
Yes, sir.
Not able to find out a single solution. Correct? So, you have to see ki how many variables are in your equation. If x plus y equal to 100, in this equation, there are two variables, x and y. So, we need minimum two equations to solve this kind of equation. If there is only one equation given in two variables, like here, x plus y equal to 100, then there is not a single answer. There will be infinite answer starting with x equal to 1, y equal to 99. X equal to 2, y equal to 98.
Yes, sir.
X equal to 3, y equal to 97. So, Gaurav, you understood? If I am giving you a linear equation in two variables, only one, you will be not able to give me one answer. There will be thousands, crores answer, infinite answer. If there are two variables, then we need at least two equations to solve this. If we have three variables, like here, 3x plus 5y plus 9z minus 16 equal to 0. So, to solve this, we need at least three equations. Why three equations? Because there are three variables here. Okay. Clear? Got it? Yeah. So, we are moving to next. Yeah. So, linear equation in two variables. It is x plus y equal to 7. You cannot give me a single answer of this equation. Here x and y. X is 0, then y is 7. X is 1, then y is 6. X is 2, then y is 5. X is 3, then y is 4. X is 4, then y is 3. So, number of solution of equation x plus y equal to 7 is infinite. And the reason? Because this is two variable and one equation. Now, find the solution which will satisfy this equation, x plus y equal to 7 and x minus y equal to 1. Here, there are two equations and there are two variables. So, I can say, yes, definitely I can get one answer for this pair of equations. That is why it is called, the subject name was system of linear equation in two variables. Why system? There are two equations, set of two equations. Answer is x equal to 4 and y equal to 3. And this solution is unique. You will not get any other value of x and y which will satisfy the both equations. So x plus y is 7, x minus y equal to 1. If you solve it, you will get x equal to 4, y equal to 3. How? Put here. 4 plus 3, 7. 4 minus 3 is 1. So, this value of x and y are satisfying this both the equations. So, these are the solution of this equation. If the equations are in x, y, z, you need at least 3 equations to solve it. A set of two linear equations in two variables is called a pair of linear equations in two variables. So, in today's class, we are going to understand these things only. How we are going to solve this equation. This is pair. Pair means two. Linear means having only one power and only one variable in one term. In two variables, x and y, that is two equations. Now, we are going to learn how to solve it graphically. Then you will really understand why it is called linear. Solving a pair of linear equations in two variables by graphical method. Solve following pair of linear equations by graphical method. Solution. To solve the system by graphical method, graph both equations and determine where the line intersects. This is the graph. x minus y equal to minus 1. You take 2 points, put x equal to 0, then y equal to 1. This is x equal to 0, y equal to 1. Then second time, take y equal to 0. So y equal to 0, x equal to minus 1. So 2 points are there. Make a straight line. This is for first equation. Now you will understand why it is called linear. Because if you draw the graph of this equation, it will come a line. That is why from line it becomes linear. For 2x plus y equal to 4, make a graph. It will cut here. The both graph will cut here. And that point is x equal to 1 and y equal to 2. So 1 and 2 are solution of this pair of linear equation. How? Put x equal to 1 and y equal to 2. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. 2x, 2 into 1, 2, plus 2, 2 plus 2, 4. So this particular point is satisfying both the equation. That is why it is a solution of this pair of straight line. So what is
your voice clear, sir?
What is pair of straight line?
Hello?
Two lines. If you draw the equation of two lines,
yes sir, your voice is not clear, sir.
And the point where it cuts becomes,
yes sir,
solution point. Ajay, I have also given a speaking power to you. You can also ask questions now. It is previously it was only with Gaurav. Is it clear how to solve by graphical method? Take both the equation, draw a graph. Whenever they are cutting at the point, it is the solution of the equations. Is it clear, Gaurav? Yeah. So now I am moving to hello. Is it clear, Gaurav? My voice is not clear. Okay. Now is it clear? I don't know what happened. Yeah, okay. Now we are moving to solve the following pair of linear equation by graphical method. To solve the system by graphical method, graph both the equation and determine where the line intersects. Look, these two lines are parallel. So parallel lines will never meet. So if lines are parallel, they don't have any solution. In the previous example, I have shown you that this line, in the previous slide, you have seen that both the lines were cutting at a point and this is the solution. In this particular example, both the lines are parallel. So parallel lines will not have a solution. Although there are two equations, but the two equations doesn't mean that they have a solution. It is like India and Pakistan. They don't have any common point. Let us see the third equation. The third equation is like this. Solve the following pair of linear equation by graphical method. Here you will see very interesting thing. For first line, this is the equation. X minus 2y equal to minus 4. Strangely, the second line actually is the same line. It is on the same graph. That means, actually there are not two equations. Only one equation is given, and the second equation is just a representation of the first equation in a second form. How? Multiply the first equation by 3. First equation is x minus 2y equal to minus 4. If you multiply by 3, it becomes 3x minus 6y equal to minus 12.
Yes, sir.
As I taught in my previous class, Gaurav, that
yes, sir.
In any equation, if you multiply same constant both sides of the equal to sign, actually equation is same. Or you add something both sides of the equal to equation will remain same. So in such cases, this is
equation
that there are two equations. In fact, there are one equation, and if there is only one equation, you know that the solutions are infinite. Right? So this is graphical. Now I will teach you how to solve algebraically. This is the graphical method. Is it clear, both of you? Actually, Gaurav, those students, we are moving. System of linear equation in two variables have either no solution, one solution, or infinite many solutions. Determined graphically. How? If they are cutting, that they have exactly one solution. If they are parallel, they don't have any solution. If both the equations are same, मतलब एक लाइन के ऊपर दूसरा लाइन आ जाता है, वन लाइन इज ऑन द अनदर लाइन, देन एक्चुअली इट इज द सेम इक्वेशन एंड देन इनफाइनाइट मेनी सॉल्यूशन आर देयर. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द ग्राफिकल मेथड. नाउ एल्जेब्रिक कंडीशन फॉर नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस, सेम थिंग एल्जेब्रिकली विदाउट ड्रॉइंग the graph, how you will know. Suppose a1x plus b1y equal to c1, a2x plus b2y equal to c2 are two equations, and algebraically you have to find out whether this pair of equation have any solution, no solution, or infinite solution. So one way I have taught you, draw a graph and find out algebraically. Take the ratio of coefficient of x, that is a1 by a2, and then take ratio of coefficient of y, jo y mein guna hai, that is b1 by b2. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, that means it say the system has a unique solution. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, but not equal to c1 by c2, that means these are parallel line and the system has no solution. And if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2, that means it is really only one equation in two form. So there are infinite solutions. So whenever you get a linear equation, before solving it, first find out whether you can get a solution or not. Otherwise, doing a lot of work, you will come to know, no, there is no solution possible. Now I am going to teach you substitutional method. So what is substitutional method? From the name, it seems that you have to substitute one for other. Let there are two equations, 2x plus y equal to 8 and x minus 3y equal to minus 3. So just take any equation, equation first or equation two, whatsoever you like, and then bring one variable left hand side to equal to and take other variable in right hand side, like this. Select any one equation and solve for any one variable in term of other. Here what I am telling, I am taking the second equation. Here x minus 3y equal to minus 3. So x equal to 3 minus 3y will go right side, right hand side of equal to, and it become plus. So this become plus 3y minus 3. So from any one of the equation, find out value of one variable in term of another variable. Here I am taking the second equation, and now x equal to 3y minus 3. The second step is, whatever you have got here, put in the another equation. From the equation number 2 we have found out this. So I will put x equal to 3y minus 3 in equation number 1, not 2, because from 2 only you have got this one na. Jisse liya hai usko kya doge. So you have substitute the expression for x into the first equation. So here x equal to 3y minus 3, the equation is 2x plus y equal to 8. So in place of, for you I have stopped for a few seconds. So substitute the expression for x into the first equation. So here x equal to 3y minus 3. So I will put in the first equation. 2x plus y equal to 8. 2 multiply by x. What is x? 3y minus 3. 3y minus 3 plus y equal to 8. From this equation, because everything is in y, I can easily find out the value of y. Solve the equation produced in step 2. So what is this? 6y plus minus 6 plus y equal to 8. This is 7y equal to 8 plus 6, and the 7y equal to 14, and this means y equal to 2. So it is y equal to 2. So we got one solution, y equal to 2. Now put this y equal to 2 either in equation 1 or in equation 2, whatever you want. So I am taking this one, x minus 3y equal to minus 3. So y equal to 2, so put here 2. So x equal to 6 minus 3 equal to 3. So we got the answer x equal to 3 and y equal to 2. Now whether this equation is right or this solution is right or wrong, to check it, put the value of x and y in both the equations. So x is 3, put here 2 into 3 minus y you will get, sorry, this is I think printing mistake, it should be plus. So 6 plus 2 is 8. This is printing mistake, it should be basically like this, plus. From second equation, x minus 3y equal to minus 3. That is x minus 3, 2, it is minus 3. So this equation is solved. This equation is called substitutional method, because in one of the equation we substitute the variable x equal to x in term of y, and we put this variable in the second equation. That is why it is called substitutional method. We substitute x for y. Now Yeah. So this, I want to show you how we are going to solve it. So 5x plus 2y equal to 11, 3x plus 4y equal to 15. So the method is elimination method. In this method, we choose here, it is 5x, it is 3x. It is 2y, it is 4y. So either we can solve for y or we can solve for x. Here I am deciding to solve for y. So what I will do? I will multiply equation 1 by 2. And whatever is coming, that equation 2 will be, so I will subtract from this. Why 2? Because if I multiply by 2, it becomes 4y here. And here it is 4y. That is why I want to make at least one term equal to in both the equations. So multiplying equation by 2, I will get 10x plus 4y equal to 22. As I told, if you multiply or divide any equation by one constant, the equation remains same. So in equation 1, I have multiplied by 2. Now what is my equation? Second equation, 3x plus 4y equal to 15. Now I will subtract equation 2 from 1. So 10x minus 3x, it becomes 7x. 4y will cut, and 22 minus 15, it is 7. From this, x equal to 1. Now this x equal to 1, I will put either in equation 1 or equation 2. There is no problem. So I am putting it in equation 2. So equation 2, 3 into x. So it becomes 3 into 1 plus 4y equal to 15. So this 3 into 1 is 3, this both this side. So 4y equal to 15 minus 3. That is equal to 12. So y equal to 12 by 4. That is equal to 3. So the answer is x equal to 1 and y equal to 3. So this is called equation by non-zero constant. Here I am multiplying by 2. Whatever I have done, I am just showing again here. So here I have multiplied by 2. So that is the demand, that is the art, what constant I should multiply. Then whether I should add or whether I should subtract, that is also you have to apply brain. Here 4y is the same thing, so that is why I have subtracted. If had it been minus, then I could have added it. And the last one is, so this is elimination method. Before that, we have already studied that was substitutional method.
Then write x equal to minus y equal to 1, and then forget this value, and then y b1 c2 minus b2 c1, then in here minus y by, forget this y, then a1 c2 minus a2 c1 equal to 1, forget this value, then a1 b2 minus a2 c1 and then x equal to this and y equal to this. Let us see, two equations are given, 5x plus 2y minus 11 equal to 0 and 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. So x by 2 into minus 15, it is minus 30 minus 11 into 4, that is minus 44, that is plus 44 now, minus minus. And minus y equal to 5 into minus 15 minus 3 into minus 11 and then 1 by 5 into 4, that is 20, minus 3 into 2, that is 6. So x equal to 1 and y equal to 3. If you put this value of x and y in these two equations, you will see that this will satisfy the equations. So x equal to 1 and y equal to 3 is solution of the given two equations.